Hello, welcome to this EDEM API video where I'm going to go through the conversion of an API model from CPU format to CUDA GPU format. This is an extension of a previous video where I've looked at updating the API versioning and also creating an API, the introduction to the API. So here we have the simulation model. It's run and runs okay on the CPU. If we go to the particle body force, you can see that the solver is just set for CPU, it doesn't support GPU. In our model, we actually have some elements of the GPU set up already. You can see we've got a GPU file name referenced. One of the main components of CPU to GPU is making sure that the information read from the external preference file also gets read to the GPU. To do this, we set up simulation parameters or particle parameters if they're particle specific parameters. And those parameters are then transferred from the CPU to the GPU at the start of the programming sequence. But first, let's start with the GPU file. So we're specifying a GPU file name. So simply, we can start by creating a text file, copy and paste that name, make sure the extension is CU for CUDA solver. Now, I can actually see that it says it's CUDA compatible already. However, that is an empty text file. So if we run the simulation, we would expect it to give us an error because it's trying to compile that empty file and won't allow it to run. But it does give us an idea of what's required. So it's required to config for time step and external force functions. So it's quite easy to add the CUDA file in as a resource. It's just a way of editing it. You can use any text editor. But this instance means continuing with Visual Studio. So there was external force and the properties to add. So let's have a look at the help files. If we go to the API help for the index, which is installed with EDEM, it opens up actually the GPU update, skip past the OpenCL part, look at the CUDA solver updates. You can see here that you want either calculate force for particle geometry models or external force as well as the config time step functions. Let's copy the external force into our text document. So this is a function that EDEM is saying was not there. And I've copied the other two there as well. As I was mentioning, the preference file information needs to be copied through. So that's the density and the viscosity. We already have a structure for this. So let's paste these in, and it requires a little bit of formatting. Also take the opportunity to add in the device which is needed. It needs to be at the start of every external function in the CUDA GPU. Going back to the density and viscosity, this is a part where it's best to copy an existing example. So what we have here is field query parameters, setting up something called field query data. And we do it using simulation get parameter data. Then we're assigning density and the viscosity to these field query parameters dot density and viscosity. So that's the preference file format out the way. We can kind of go into the main body of the code. So the first thing to do is essentially copy our CPU code. It's been already updated, so it's a very similar format. So we can copy and paste it in. Doubles are not necessarily used on the coup de sol. We want to use reel or long reel. You can see that a reel will be a double float, a double or float depending on the precision mode used. So typically what we'll do is find all references to double and replace it with a reel, and then depending on the solver type, you then will automatically convert this to the correct format. The same for vectors. These are either the same, so it's reel 3 for a vector, or long reel 3 if you want a double precision. Then let's have a look at some of the other formatting changes for it. The CFD field is okay, radius, power function is okay, so particle.volume. Let's refer to the help again. You can see particle, all the functions here start with get, so get velocity, get volume. So you just need to do a replacement here for the particle to get volume. Cross-sectional area calculation is okay. The gravity, here we're predefining the gravity vector. You can actually, in the latest versions of the API, both on CPU and GPU, it's an easier function on GPU, just use the get gravity function. We could leave it as it is, but let's change this to get the gravity. It gets the gravity value, which is set in the EDEM creator. Applying the buoyancy forces, we just need to change the particle get volume option. Then the field query is one function which is used within the code, so query vector field. If we go into this by the help, let's copy the full function in, just so we have the right format for the GPU. So query vector field, we need to define where this comes from. So you can see here it's field data dot query vector field. And it's expecting a field ID first. So on the CPU we use a field name, on the GPU we use a field ID, so this is ID1. There is a way of automatically copying the ID, but in this example it's quite simple just to hard code this ID in. Target point is a particle position, so using the same format, particle get position. Number of points, we had 8 in the previous model, so 8 in the same. Interpolation type, inverse distance weighting. In this case, it's a value of 0, means the same to match what's on the CPU. And the result, we're expecting a vector, reel 3. So we can set this to CFD field to match what we previously had, although previously we had the X, Y, and Z components. So maybe let's just predefine this as a vector, so it makes it slightly simpler to manage. Then we can remove our CPU component of the code here, and just a bit of formatting. The fluid velocity vector has been presented as a vector, so we don't need step 2 here. We can delete this. And the particle velocity, it's okay as it is. We can though just get the particle velocity as a vector as well, so maybe it's a bit easier to read if we set it as particle get velocity. Either format is okay. The helper function should define the pluses and minuses okay. The dot length functions, multiplications, no, unchanged, so the Reynolds number is okay. And there we go, the results function. Let's check what Edem is expecting here. So it's result is get, set, and add total force. As we mentioned previously, we don't want to overwrite any existing contact forces on the particle, so it's result and add the force we're calculating from the field, rather than overwriting any previously calculated forces with the field force. So that should be the model fully updated to GPU format. However, not every code runs well straight away, so let's run and see there's an error generated. In fact, three main errors here. Defining pi, defining is zero, and the drag coefficient, all undefined in the code. Let's go back and check these components. So the drag coefficient is just, we just need to set it. It was set separately in the header file of the CPU, so it's the same equivalent in the GPU. What is pi in this case? So let's search the help just to determine what the pi function is. You can see it's CUDA API constants. Pi gives us actually the value that we're using. And we just need to tell EDEM that this is what we mean by pi. So I could write it into the cross-sectional area calculation or define it here as from the CUDA API constants. Then the final one was is zero. So we're checking if the Reynolds number is not zero in this case. So let's go back to the help files again, just to check how this function should be defined. Start with the top one, C utilities, math. We can see that there's a few different functions useful to have a look. Reading it, we can see it's CUDA plugin interface, C utilities, math. So just need to tell you that's the function that we're using to determine if something is zero. So there we go, the model runs, compiles when you press play, runs okay, and is solving on the GPU CUDA solver. So I hope that quick update was useful in terms of converting an API model from CPU to GPU. This model is a bit more advanced in that it has a field data, but for the most part, we just need to convert our doubles and our vectors to reals or real three, and then make sure that the particle or the geometry or the simulation functions are just defined correctly. In this case, with the get options.